Welcome back, my friends, to Empire Total War. My name is Saf, and today's episode of the Darth Maul series, as the Ottoman campaign, we're going to be looking at pushing this army of the Mughal Empire, commanded by Ram Suresh, out of our territory, or just annihilating it altogether. It's part of our ongoing mission to finally get some kind of counterattack going here against our two greatest rivals of this campaign, the Mughal Empire in the Eastern Front and the Russians in the Northern Front. The one with the Russians has actually gone pretty well to start with. Last episode, we retook Crimea from them. We used to own this territory. We managed to hold on to it for a little while, but then we eventually lost it. But we finally regained that ground. So we've now got a little bit of a buffer. Being repaired, the army. It's going to cost 1,500 to retrain, but I don't have the finances to cover that for the moment. But we also have our other army over here pushing towards Astrakhan. And we're going to see if we can gain some ground over here as well. Next target really is going to be Cherkask. That will completely unify the coastline of the Black Sea and basically isolates this Russian navy here, which also has a large army on board, mostly made up of fifth-rate ships. There is a brig in there. There's a sixth-rate ship in there. Everything else is a fifth-rate by the looks of things, so they've got two light ships and the rest are fifths. We do have our own fleet being constructed steadily. We're introducing one ship at a time in various ports. We've got a Zebek being built there. We have a fifth rate being built there. I think those are the only two ships. And we've got another Zebek here. So we've got two Zebeks and a fifth rate being built to add to our own navy. What else? That's more or less it. That's pretty much it for the update, so let's get straight into fighting Ram Suresh. So it's about even. They have the advantage in numbers, by the looks of things. Only by about 100 men, though. 115 men they outnumber me by. They have two elephants, which is basically going to count for nothing when I launch my three cannons at them. They have three mortars. As long as I stay out of their range, which is very short, I will be fine. And I have the advantage of range, 900, 900... 900 and 600 compared to their 3 500s, so we are all good to go with this one. Their spawn point, just so that they can try and get in range of my infantry in favor. At least we can then maybe hold back. I hope we have good terrain. We'll find out in a second. And boom, oh, we do have good terrain. Look at that. Got a nice big hill up top. Oh, this is perfect. So this should hopefully be out of range. Oh, look at that. Our cannons go stretch far beyond the hills. Right, let's take our guys out of formation here. Let's put them lined up nicely on this hill. I think what I'll do is I might get these guys to target. Oh, I've selected all four of them. Ha! Whoops, I thought I only selected three. Never mind. I might get most of them to target the enemy mortars, just to neutralize them, and I might get one of them to go for the enemy elephants as well. Alright, let's move everything else back for a second. So we do have a defensive wall here. We are attacking, so we don't really want to be too defensive in this. I'm just going to stretch my line out quite a bit here, just to cover everything. And we'll use this line here. Might make that a bit... Actually, let's make that a bit smaller. There we go. Right, so we're going to have my melee troops behind my cannons just to support. Got two units of cavalry I'm going to put on my left. And I've got my general, which I'll keep out of the way on top of the hill. Alright. Right, mortars. Oh, they are in range of me. Damn, I thought I was out. I thought I'd be out of range. We're going to take some casualties from the mortars then. Oh, we've just destroyed two mortars right there. And good thing is anything that overshoots is going to hit. Oh, look at all the elephants have gone down. I kind of feel bad. But it's a necessary evil. Oh boy, we're actually probably going to take quite a few casualties here, I think, from those mortars. They're in range of my cannons as well. Oh, they destroyed two of my cannons. Oh, you dicks. Two of my mortars have gone down. Right, cavalry. You need to flank those mortars now, please. Man, we have not done a lot of damage to these mortars at all. I'm rather disappointed. In the past, we've been pretty good. Right, let's change targets. We need to start hitting some of this infantry. The enemy cavalry is getting wrecked. The native lancers just got destroyed by my front line. So we're going to move my cavalry all the way around here. Don't care if it tires my guys out. We are getting on top of that hill and we are running down those mortars. Because our men are going down. And as we all know, AI mortars are ridiculously accurate. Right. Elephants are routed. Start targeting some of this lot back here. Oh, we've got some hidden enemy infantry. Intercept. Form line. Charge. Their infantry line, their infantry is just getting decimated here at the moment. So we're doing okay here. Oh, let's start targeting some of this mass routing unit. Get all the shots we can in this pile with our cannons. Enemy general killed. Right, let's try and push forward. We need to try and disrupt these mortars. No matter the cost. Right, that's one mortar disrupted. My house is to aim for this elephant here, actually. Push on to the next mortar. Just keep moving, keep moving. I'm going to start pushing my infantry forward here. So let's run. These guys forward. Oh, hold up. Infantry coming in. Push the line forward. Come on, push forward. Oh, I don't even know what units are which now. That last mortar. Push forward, attack those dervishes. The other two units move up. Okay. Push forward. Right, cannons, you can hold fire. I'm going to get my cavalry to start running down some of these routing troops. So have all the mortars been destroyed? Oh, we've got some three men there. Elephants are retreating. So we're going to run down some of these bigger units here. Bring my general down in the angle this way. Charge. So we've got some bowmen over on this side. Let's move these two units over there. Thankfully, my guys aren't tired, so they can actually gain some ground against these enemy infantry quite quickly, so we can get some volleys against them. That'll do. Actually, ignore that unit. Come back into the center where most of these other units are. And general. Head over this way. We are running these guys down. Casualties are piling up for the Mughal Empire here. Okay, there goes their last unit. Continue, we need to run down as much as we can. Get my general up this way. Dervishes in under 20 men. Let's double back and hit these 100. General, move up. Come on, let's go. So we need to wipe this army out. Too many have run for the battlefield. We got them down to 184 from like 300 and something, so that's not too bad. Okay. It's just this group of 17 now. Oh, that'll do. That will do. Heroic victory. In our favour, that battle. 307 men lost for 3,200 of the enemies. So 1,000 men still managed to escape. That's kind of annoying. Right, let's just occupy our structure here. Okay, so counterattack has been pretty successful so far. Taking Russian ground. Pushing into more Russian territory. We've beaten back another Mughal Empire army. We've got this force here. Not made up of a lot, but it's still causing problems. So we just need to be aware of that. But we also need to be aware of that full stack Russian army that's in the middle of its navy over in the Mediterranean. So got to be a bit aware of where that's going to go. Well, crap. This was unexpected. Oh, well, at least we got Sweden to join in, and they were abandoned by their allies. Well, crap. This is not what I was expecting. We've always been on friendly terms with... I really did not need... Right on the verge of us making our counterattack as well. This is just stupid. Oh, dearie me. How is that going to impact my economy as well? We were trading with Austria, I believe. Weren't we? Or were we? I can't remember now. if we were, that's probably going to impact us quite a lot because they were on our border. Come on, Sweden, help me out here. You're my only friend in this world. Stop raiding my stuff, would you please? It's annoying. $4,356. Trade agreement cancelled with Austria. You can see how that's impacted our economy. It's on the decline again. So that's repaired. This needs to be repaired. Okay. New town emerges. I'm gonna need all the money I can get, so give me industry, please. What are they put in there? They recruited some stuff there. Well, I could go and occupy this Austrian fort instead, rather than going for the Ukraine. Austria owns Poland as well. I kind of already wanted to go for Kiev. To be honest though, this army's not really going to do much against Kiev. It's a fortified city, it's probably not going to last very long. At least I can retrain that army. So let's double back on ourselves. Let's go towards Lvov. Is that how you pronounce it? Lvov. We're going to go occupy this fort anyway. It's mine now. Suck it, Austria. God, look at that army. I don't know what its range is. Need more units. Oh, Janissary hand mortars. Okay. Thankfully, a lot of their military seems to be elsewhere. Oh, and I do have this army here in Venice that I can now move across. I could go and attack Zagreb. Could force their navy, the Austrian navy made up of mostly fifth rates, just like the Russians, could force them out of their port, and I could go and attack Zagreb and gain some ground here. So if I took the army out, people are still happy. So I could send reinforcements from Bosnia. Or I could just leave a irregular unit in Venice, or perhaps leave behind one of my line infantry units, maybe my most experienced one. I can't really. Well, the people are happy. I guess I could leave it for the moment. It's not going to get attacked anytime soon, by the looks of things. There's no troops around. I'll leave one unit behind. The rest of the force can go after Zagreb. Slow down the game a bit. So Austria have declared war, but we're going to make the first moves. Command your surrender. Surrender refused. Okay, that's fine. So we've made the first moves. Well, they've moved into our territory, but we've taken their fort up here. Fort I don't know how you pronounce that. And now we're attacking Zagreb, so we're going to take this little bit of territory here, this little scrap of land. What else can we do? Well, that Russian army is not coming over this way, so I could send these troops back to Anatolia, sorry. Take these guys back there as well. March. Now, what am I going to do here? Do I double back and face off against this force, or should I head... I guess I should push on and try and drive this army out. I'm not going to bother repairing this, because I think this army's probably going to head down there anyway. Path blocked. Well, yeah, of course it is. Okay, so that's that sorted. Let's push on towards Astrakhan. Okay. And we're just sort of waiting for this army to replenish. Right then. Let's attack Zagreb, shall we? Men against 1224. What's that mortar's range? Fixed artillery, 500 range. Okay. To the east, the Mughal Empire. Oh dear. We can't be attacked from the south because I own that. So, we're more or less surrounded everywhere else. We can't exactly escape south. Okay. Let's form up on this hill. I want to try and stay out of their mortar's range this time. Well, I say theirs. Last time it was the Mughal Empire. Got my irregulars. My high duty regulars. Okay, where are those mortars? Right there. They can't shoot me. Haha, sucks to be you. It's a nice scenic area. I like this. I think we're gonna like it here in Zagreb. Did we hit anything? We did not. That's unfortunate. He died, apparently. This townhouse, the town hall is going to get demolished. Oh no, he didn't die. Oh yeah, he did. Yeah, he did, sorry. And we also killed one infantryman somewhere. Did he die of a heart attack somewhere or something? I can't see him on the ground. They've still got four mortars. I'm not moving my infantry forward. I'm going to let them march up towards me. With two of their units, apparently. I mean, my guys are miles out of range by the looks of things, but I don't really want to come forward too much. I'll move my cavalry along the flank over here. See if I can pressure them a little bit. Nothing? No? Okay. I guess I should move down a little bit. For my cannon to fire, there we go. So I'll run them so I don't shoot my own guys as they fire. Oh, so we've only got one gun. Well, you've only got one cannon shooting at those mortars now. Can the others shoot at the ground? Maybe we can get some accidental kills by shooting the ground. Like that. That's what we want. Okay, let's move my light troops. I don't know where that... Okay, that infantry's going this way. So if I bring my... Can I run down this hill at all? I cannot. So the only way for the only exit for my light infantry is to come down this way. Destroyed one of the mortars. Let's aim for that ground there. So we have three of my line infantry. Each of my line infantry facing off against the enemies. There we go. Cavalry is primed in position there on the side. Ah, only one of my guns can fire now. I guess I should probably just demolish this building then. Maybe some of the falling debris can kill some of these guys. You know what? Let's not bother. Let's start shooting their infantry. I can always use my cavalry or something. Go, Cav, go. This is a very brief army as well. I wasn't expecting to go to war with Austria, so I kind of didn't really plan anything. This is very much a case of whatever troops I had available are attacking. Thankfully, Zagreb was undefended, so... And most of Austria's forces seem to be up in the north, because they've been going to war with Poland, it looks like. Maybe we can get some kind of diplomacy with Poland now. But at least we'll be able to make... At least we'll be able to spill the first blood against Austria. As revenge for this betrayal. Look at that. That's better. Oh, they're forming line now. Start aiming for this other unit here at the back. And my horsemen are over here. Oh, they're getting shot at by the mortars. Move, horses, move. Thankfully, the enemy mortars are not being very accurate right now. Stretch out the line. Oh, just missed that guy. Keep moving. I slammed that right-hand unit there. Or the right hand of that unit. These guys are a little bit off angle. Let's re-angle them a bit here. I'm kind of worried these guys are going to shoot my people in the back, so I'm not going to get them to fire. I'm just going to let this front unit do the shooting. Oh, we lost three guys there. Where did three of my cavalrymen get killed? Oh, there, as they were crossing the fence. Oh, my infantry are not in range. They have better, their infantry has better range than mine. Oh wow, our cannon just ripped through that unit there. This is militia as well. How come militia's better range than us? Let's bring my cavalry over here. My light units are having a field day here. I'm actually going to bring them forward a bit. Try and get this other unit to get involved. See if we can shoot over the top of my guys. Yep, they can. Thank goodness for that. No friendly fire there. Phew, that's close. My cannons finished their volley. That'll do. We don't want to waste any more time wiping these citizenry of the garrison, really, isn't it? So, 104 men lost in that one, that's alright. And we've gained a territory. Lovely. So we've gained some ground against Austria already. Region captured. Croatia is now part of the Ottoman Empire. Okay, let's have a quick look at diplomacy here. In fact, I don't even know. Let's see if we can get peace with people. France doesn't want it. Austria is obviously not going to take it, but I thought I'd give it a try anyway. Okay, so where's Poland? Unfriendly. We can't get anything with them, so we can't really get anything with anybody. Well, Russia, unlikely, but wait, what? Oh God, peace signed. Oh, I wasn't actually expecting that. Wow. Okay. Well, my income's just shot up to 5,000. What trade? Are you having to get trade? Maybe. No. So not with, oh no, they are. They did. 7,000. Okay. That was unexpected. Right, now I need to completely oh Jesus. I need to completely change my plans now. Right, I'm going to need to think on this. I've now freed up two full stack armies, which I was not expecting to do. One of them can be, this one here can be committed to fighting against Austria, that's for sure. Let's end the turn. Let's get some money in the bank and then I can set things up for the next episode. Okay, wow. I don't really know what to do because I wasn't expecting that. I just thought I'd do it on a whim. And my whim was correct. Oh, Sophia is undefended. Whoops. Whoopsies. I have a couple of mortars. Right, okay, let's not bother doing that then. Okay, next episode then we're going to start off with the defense of Sofia in Bulgaria. Wow, I wasn't expecting that. Oof. What to do? Okay, so the full stack army in Crimea. I'm going to commit that to fighting against Austria, obviously. But I'm going to need to make sure that I keep some troops in... I need to recruit some troops in Crimea. Make sure that doesn't fall to Russia again when Russia inevitably backstab me like Russia, like Austria have done. The full stack that was in Russia's territory a little bit more over to the... that was going for Astrakhan. That army can... I might leave a few units behind in Chechnya, which is where they came from. And I'll send the rest of them against the Mughal Empire. So I now have two armies I can use against the Mughal Empire, which is good. that full stack Russian army can't do anything now, the one that's in its navy. So it's not going to attack me anyhow for the moment. Oh dear. I honestly wasn't expecting it. I thought I'd do it on a whim, and okay, they accepted. They obviously didn't. They're obviously getting a bit weakened by something. Obviously weakened by our conflict, but they must be fighting something else, because I wasn't. They've been resilient not to accept surrender this entire time. Oh well, what's that range of that cannon as well? 800. Oh dear. Well, this is not a battle we're going to win, but I can at least do some damage. Right, I'm going to have to save it here, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And see you all in the next episode to see where this interesting turn of events is going to go.